Hello, my name is Laura Mioli-Farragon, and this is Analyzing Learning from Manhattan College's first hybrid format course on virtual reality. So the course, it's called Virtual Reality, Perception, Production, Possibilities. It is listed as COM 470, a special topics course offered in spring 2020, but it is offered to all students at the school. So you don't have to be a communication major to take this course. The content discussion and assignments are presented in Moodle Learning Management System, and our in-person sessions are used for hands-on exploration and practice with VR technology, such as the Oculus Quest, 360 cameras, and other technology that they'll be exposed to. So VR is a multi-billion dollar global industry, and it's growing each day. So there's a really important need for this class right now, especially when we're talking about communication, we're talking about technology, business. There are so many uses for VR, and it's going to be a great class for our students to be able to put on their resume and their portfolio. So this course introduces virtual reality technology and the various uses of the medium from its inception until today. And the main aspects of this course provide a foundation in understanding human perception, ethical considerations, and the basics of designing in an Unreal Engine. So we have three kind of building blocks to the course. We start with perception, and the goal for our student, for our course, is to compare and contrast virtual reality experiences alongside traditional forms of storytelling and gaming. Also to discuss the ethical impact of virtual reality technology on our society. The next building block is production. So we want the students to be able to utilize modern virtual reality technology to interact with and design VR experiences. So they're going to be creating something that they could put on their portfolio, and the assignments are designed so that they make that VR experience something that they can share with people who don't have a VR headset. So the possibilities aspect of the course, we want the students to be able to identify and apply key principles, definitions, and ethical considerations of VR technology and human perception to the design process. They'll also be able to examine and appraise new advances in VR technology and the future of VR through self-guided research. The stakeholders in this data research project are our undergraduate students who are enrolled in the course for spring 2020. Those are our subjects. And our clients, Michael Grabowski and myself, are co-instructors, and we're going to be measuring the results of this class. So our IRB proposal has been approved, and we are looking to use this content and this information for the communication department at Manhattan College, also for any other department who wants to run a class that is hybrid format or other types of things that they can use from this data. The objective of the data collection is to provide feedback for the instructor to improve the course for the next cohort, to prompt any course format changes on an institutional level, including whether prerequisites should be required to take this course or changing the hybrid format to a fully in-person class. We also want to be able to indicate students' preferences of learning modalities as a multimedia approach to content is being taken for this course. So we gave them a lot of videos, podcasts, and interactive content, as opposed to just a textbook. Because it's VR, it has a lot of visual aspect to it, so we wanted to use that. The objective of the data is also to serve as marketing materials for this course into the future. Now, our technology instrument is Google Forms. We're using a pre and post survey presented in the first and final weeks of the Moodle course. This is a protected data set, and participation is optional and has no impact on the students' grades. The instruments. So our pedagogic theories, we are incorporating teaching methods such as self-regulated learning, design thinking, and discovery learning into a blended hybrid model for this course. And so in that way, we're hoping to prepare students for a real world work environment that is project-based. Our IRB application was approved, as I said, and at the end of the course, we'll be combining the data from the surveys to complete a research paper with our findings. In this example, the Google Forms results would tell us that before the class, students were split between their preference for in-person and hybrid courses, which you see on the left. But after the class, they all unanimously preferred a hybrid format, which is an example on the right. That would tell us that the hybrid format of the class was a success. And hopefully we would have more than one or two responses, but there are 8 people enrolled in the course. And hopefully if all of them participate, we'll have a good set of data to measure against. And as the course goes on, if we want to measure the second round of it and the third round, we'll gather more and more data, which will be helpful. Data sets and categories. Here are the 4 major categories we'll be using for the collected data. We'll be using it to improve the course, for institutional decision making, for multimodal learning styles to tell us if that's effective, and for marketing. Here are some sample results for measuring the effectiveness of multimodal content from the post-class survey. So we asked them, which of the following assigned to you during your course was the most effective in helping you understand and retain the subject matter? And from this response, we found that videos, lecture, and the discussion board in Moodle were the most helpful for the student. This in particular, we would question the podcast that we chose. We would say, well, was this a good use of the podcast? Was this a good podcast to choose? Should we have chose something else? Should we not include podcasts at all? Do our students not like podcasts? Was the textbook not effective? Was the textbook too long, or maybe it was not the correct content for them? Maybe they preferred learning in different ways. So this will be very helpful as we are able to gather more responses. And we might be able to plan for more or less of these different types of content in the next round of the course. So some external limitations we have to the data collection is that at Manhattan College, hybrid format courses are not traditionally used for undergraduate classes. So this is really going to be important for telling us if this age group responds well to the hybrid format, if they're able to self-pace their own learning. And we're also creating the first VR lab in our college history, which is a very expensive thing to do. We have to buy lots of VR headsets and set up the space and test out everything. And the technology is very expensive and time consuming to implement. Some internal limitations we have is that VR is a quickly evolving technology. This is a difficult course. Lots of technology and lots of self-regulated learning is involved. The theory is similar to their other courses, so the textbook and the ideas behind VR, but will these undergraduates be able to learn the Unreal Engine, how to use the Oculus Quest, and complete the assignments in time? That's what we're going to find out. So they have to learn very difficult technology, and they have to self-pace their own work to mimic project-based workplace environments. So this will hopefully prepare them for that kind of world and will hopefully be a very helpful course for our students. Thank you.